Let me show you a form builder that's called GoZen. Right now, for a limited time, it's on a lifetime deal. So let's go check it out. So one of the key features of GoZen is that it has a step form. What does that mean? Well, instead of being a static one-page form where everything is in a single page, it has a step form, similar to Typeform. But you can also use the one-page form builder also. So right now, if you want to take advantage of the lifetime deal, it's available for a limited time. It starts off at $69 for the lifetime deal. Let me show you really quickly what that gets you. So this is the deal right now. License tier one, which is $69, gets you access to 5 domains. So you can add 5 domains to these. 5 gigabytes file storage, 1 user, 5,000 responses per month, which is kind of a lot. It depends if you have a big fan base, then this might not be enough for you. Or if you plan this to use this with different businesses, then again, it might not be enough. 5 workspaces and unlimited forms, so you can build as many as you want. If you need more domains, more storage, etc., everything, there's license tier 3 and all the way up to license tier 5, which gives you more file storage and more users. So that's the deal. Now let's go into GoZen Forms. Now this is the main dashboard and you can build your workspaces right here. In this case, it's super easy to build a form. You can build it from scratch or you can start from a template. Let me show you really quickly some of the templates that they have available. You have all the categories on the left and we have some of the forms available here. So if there's something that's available already that you already need, it's easier to use a template because it saves you time. So for example, let's build a website design quote. I think that's interesting. We can preview this before selecting it, but in this case, we're gonna use it. By the way, I'm going to leave a demo form in the description in case you guys wanna fill it out. I'm gonna build a simple subscription form in case you want to subscribe to my email list. Now, right now it's asking for a name. I'll just keep it just as it is. I'll go ahead and continue. And let me show you what I mean by step form in the beginning. So let's go ahead and preview this template already. And step form means that it's going to jump into different sections of the form instead of being all static in one single page. So if I hit start and I can fill in my name. So for example, George, I'll hit enter. Last name, Aguilar, go enter and just go along with this. So it goes by steps. There's also a mobile preview in case you guys want to check that out. And yes, you also have the option to do a static form. Instead of being step form, slides, what they call it, it could be a single page. See how that updated? And now everything is one single page. So you do have these options. And there's a custom section if you want to do that there. Slides would be the way to go because that's what makes it interesting. I like these forms because it makes users not think about filling out a form. Because if they see a long form, users might want to skip on it. It's like, you know what, that's too long, forget about it. But in step forms, well, it doesn't look as long, it just goes step by step. Now, let me show you really quickly. So here are the elements that this particular form theme has available right now. So all these are the questions that it's asking. If I wanted to ask a question, I'll hit the plus button, and we have these options available. So it's like the short text, paragraph, all like the basic ones that all forms have, like dropdowns, ratings, numbers, etc. And the advanced ones would be payments, dates, yes, no, website, file, upload, and the payment. Payment is tied to Stripe. So if you wanna solicit payments, you can add that module there. If you wanna, for example, ask for donations, you can add that there. Net promoter score, this is an interesting one. So if you are doing questions for about how are you doing? What do you think about the product? What do you think about the company? These are good ones. So for example, you add your question here, description, and then they have available 1 to 10. And then we have the options for these. If I go into questions right here, there's the options for each of the elements that I select. So the type, is it going to be required or not? And if I select another element, we have the options on the right. So every time that I select something, it adds it on the right. So right now this is the net promoter one. And if I add another one, it's just going to add it again and again. So for example, different ones. It's gonna add it to this step form or slides, how they call it, okay? And one of the favorite features I like about this, aside from being the slide form, is the conditional logic. One of the things I like about this conditional logic is that it's going to visually show you how it actually flows. And that's pretty interesting because it helps you build it. Now, let me show you one quick conditional logic right here. If I select this address section and I can add a condition to say, you know what, if the first name, and you can say it's equal to, it's not equal to, is responded, does not contain, or does contain, you can select that there. But I'll say it's equal to, and I'll say if it equals to my name, I'm gonna tell it to jump all the way to the phone number. So I'm gonna say skip all the address and jump all the way to phone number. and it's going to show me how it's going to flow. And that's pretty interesting. I haven't seen that in many of the form builders. Now, conditional logic, I think, could be more powerful, so do consider that. For now, the conditions are this. So if this happens, etc., and the first name, these are the options that we have. It's equal to, not equal to, and so on and so forth. We can add another condition to and or, so it has to meet two criterias to actually jump into another section. But where I think it's limited in conditional logic is this. Right now, it's only available to jump to. One of the conditions that I use a lot is to hide or show a field. Why do I mean by that? So for example, if I have a drop-down menu that's asking for the, who do you want to contact? If I say support, maybe I wanted to show different type of questions or hide different type of questions. So I think they should add that conditional logic right here for the response, for the action. So something to consider. Next thing we have is the integrate. As of now, these are the integrations that are available. So direct integration to Google Sheet, MailChimp, Pavli, and all of these available. Webhook, which would be one of the most important ones. With Webhook, you can connect all the integrations that you like. There you go, all the ones available. The share one, so you can embed mode to grab the code for embed, like standard, pop-up, slide, tap, etc. And you can generate the code, and I haven't added a domain, but you can add it there. You can also view the results for the people who fill it out, the summary, and the responses. So if someone fills it out, we're gonna view all that information there. And we also have the options for the theme. So if you don't like this theme that you're actually looking at right now, I can go ahead and select this, and it changes everything, which I think is pretty interesting because it does it automatically. It's gonna do it all the way for the step form, the slide form for them. And you have all these themes available. You have my themes, gallery, etc. Next, we have the settings. So if you wanna remove the branding, you can see that there, it's just removed. Powered by GoZen, I can remove that. And that's available in the lifetime deal. If you want to show the progress bar or not, I would recommend that if you have a lot of questions, don't show the progress bar because it might make people not want to fill it out because it's going to be super long. So it's going to depend if you want to use it or not. The messages, you can edit all of these so you can translate them also if you like. So for example, if I want to make it in Spanish, I'll go instead of next, I'll go siguiente, for example, right? And edit all of that right there. Let me close this. There's also the scheduled. If you want to schedule this to start and end, if you want to use this for a sign-up form, for a concert, for a webinar, whatever, you want to give it an end date and a start date, that's possible. Limit responses, so you can, if you have 1,000 responses, that's enough, you don't want more. Allow multiple submissions, if you want to allow that or not, that's available there. And if you want to publish it, just go ahead and publish. Ready to go, here's the form, whoops, and you can unpublish it also. But if you publish it, here's the link if you want to view it. And let's go back into the main dashboard. Again, if you want to build another workspace where you have everything separated, that's also available just to keep control. Different businesses, different brands, and different conditions that you want to use it for, you can use that workflow. And you can start from scratch if you like. And we have the general settings for this, like security, domains, if you want to add your domain there, the team members, and the Stripe, if you want to add your link account, so you can add the payment gateway and receive payments through Stripe, and the API key for more advanced features. But basically, that is GoZen Forms. If you want to grab that limited time deal, that link will be provided in the description. And that's a wrap.